Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make romantic cards with the Tim Holtz Masquerade die. I cut the masks out of Ultra Smooth's card and I spray it with Distress Oxide spray, moving my spray over the mask while spraying, and then I use the heat tool to dry. Now I have used the mask before and I will link to that video above. The techniques I show you in this video can be used on other shapes too, of course. And look at how easy and pretty this is. I have another piece of Ultra Smooth card and I mist that with some water and then I put it in the embossing folder. And then I'm going to run it through the machine. And this is the result. I have Nouveau Glacier paste and a piece of corrugated cardboard. And I added a layer of gesso on the cardboard. And now I'm going to paint it with the Glacier paste. And this will give a lovely shimmer. And just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. I cut a Tim Holtz butterfly out of black cardstock and I'm going to cut it in pieces. I measure with the mask to see where I want to add it. And I move it a bit over the mask to see what is the best place and if I need to trim anything off. I'm going to add a layer of embossing powder and I add the pieces on the embossing pad and press them in the ink with a scrap piece of paper. And then I add the embossing powder and I'm going to pick up the pieces with a craft pick. I melt the embossing powder with a shaky time lapse and then I add the wings to the mask. And I put on an acrylic block to let it dry. And while drying, I ink the embossed background. I use an ink blending tool and add the most color at top and bottom. While you are here, you may like to check out the community tab at the top, available on smartphone and desktop computer. I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes, sneak peeks, polls and such. So I'd love to meet you there too. And then I'm going to add some black in the corners, and the black really makes the color pop. I added the background to a card and I'm going to add a cardboard piece. I added tape to the back and I'm going to add some white thread. Both the cardboard and thread are cheap and easy ways to get some texture on your page. I'm going to add some seed beads on the mask to cover the edges of the added wings. And I add some glue. Now this glue will dry clear, so no worries. And then I sprinkle on the seed beads and you best use a lid or something to catch the beads that roll off. And once they are on the glue, I press them in the glue a bit and move them into place. I add a bit more glue and some more beads. And I know it doesn't look pretty now, but just wait for it. For the next card I have abandoned coral and I cut a mask and I spray a diagonal, and this leaves a mist on the left side. And I dry it with a heat tool and then spray some water. This makes the ink oxidize and I dry it again. And this is the result with lots of texture. I mist the back with water and I put it in an embossing folder, and then I'm going to run it through the machine. And this is what it looks like after embossing. And now I'm going to add some Nuvo mousse. Now this is expanding mousse and that can expand beautifully. You can also use it to add little details like with regular mousse. I add a bit on my paper and then I'm going to apply it with my finger. I rub on the paper to get a bit off so there's not too much on my finger, and this makes the pattern of the embossing folder stand out more. I embossed another piece of ultra smooth card and I'm going to ink it with the same color Distress Oxide ink, but now with an ink pad and an ink blending tool. And I'm adding a lot at the bottom and blend it out towards the top. And then I'm going to add some of the mousse on the card too. And you may wonder if I couldn't have used the bit that I had left from the mask. And I didn't do this on the same day, so the answer is no. I added a piece to a note card and I sprayed a piece of corrugated cardboard with Distress Oxide spray, without gesso this time, and this soaks into the cardboard a bit more. And this makes a nice background for the mask. I have cut a butterfly out of glitter card and I cut off the wings, and I'm going to add the parts behind the mask. I add them on the same place on both sides, and this is another way to extend the mask. I add some more tape to the cardboard and I'm going to add some white thread here, so the mask will stand out a bit more. Just a bit will make a big difference. I'm going to add some pre-made drops using the same drops as a glue. And after I added a few, I ended up adding some more. So this is the finished card. And now I finish the first card. The mask is dry and I add that to the card. And I'm going to add some different size drops. And you will see what a difference a few black drops make. And this is the card after drying, and you can see the glue has dried all clear. And there you have another two ways to use the masquerade die. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting!